There are many areas of concern for Marathon Holdings PLC. So, firstly, they're so widespread that communication falls through. Time and money is wasted to regain it. IT governance is controlling the work to increase value. It provides justification on spending and controls spending such as budgeting. IT governance has different levels of maturity. The further up the chart, the more beneficial the business and efficient. IT planning is very ad hoc at the moment, which isn't very
beneficial. And is low maturity. And is at a low maturity stage. It needs to allow IT to become a corporate strategic partner, allowing it to coincide with top business decisions, increasing coordination and accountability. IVA should increase IT contribution to maximise corporate profitability and service delivery. Input resources, corporate strategies and incorporating the external environment into their IT systems will increase in leadership, IT strategy and therefore structure can occur. This leads to direct cost savings, increased capacity utilisation, time saving, customer loyalty, channel optimisation and increased productivity. IVA also needs to consider business alignment, customer orientation, operational quality and future orientation. Business alignment looks at the enterprise architecture which allows the whole business infrastructure, allowing the company to meet strategic business objectives. Customer orientation shows the company reacting to demand efficiently and effectively to increase business service concerning
how well the business is progressing. This can be a process to make sure it facilitates for their IT capabilities. It needs to focus on strategic alignment. IT governance shows how the business is very chaotic and unorganised. A good solution to this is setting measurable and realistic objectives which staff can fulfil in both long and short term. Marathon also needs to carry out a risk assessment. Marathon Holding PLC have already made one progression through resource and skill management. This involves recruitment. By recruiting a new team member with a lot of previous IT experience, they are maximising their use of human resources. Another aspect that Marathon needs to pay close attention to is their expenditure. There are three roles of IT that IVA can use to delegate their budget correctly. 75% of the total spend should maintain business momentum and run the organisation. This is a vast majority of the budget and therefore is a key aspect to the success of a business. If not enough money is spent here, communication and organisation of the business spend should be spent
on improving the business results, changing the organisation to be constantly progressing with an ever-changing need in customer demand. Lastly, 5% of the total spend should be focused on innovation. This keeps momentum high and keeps staff constantly involved. As well as IT governance, business intelligence and knowledge management is another area of concern for Marathon Holding PLC to consider. Business intelligence is used to provide an analytical data. By integrating data from across an enterprise and delivering self-service reports and analysing, IT spends less time responding to requests and business users spend less time looking for information. To manage financial assets and cost accounting, production operations and materials, personnel, plants and archive documents, software known as systems, applications and products could be used. This is coincided with customer relationship management, which could allow Marathon to measure and control direct contacts with customers. The Broadfiller Group's approach to CRM is it has a four-step process: analyse, plan, interact and measure. That comes back to customer loyalty. Gaining customer loyalty makes it easier to keep customers coming back even when mistakes are made in the business. It brings price elasticity and allows leeway for some delays as customers are loyal to the brand name, not the product as a whole. Alongside this is a complaint system, providing refunds, good customer service, substitutions, rebates and credit vouchers. Customers will feel listened to and treated well, making them want to come back, and they know customer care is to a high standard. As well as this, knowledge and experiences that individuals and group members can bring to the organisation boosts insight into which strategies would be best to use. Marathon have already considered this by hiring new staff with background experience in IT, but still could increase communication with their worldwide stores to increase knowledge from different countries. Marathon Holding PLC also needs to think about the life cycle management. Part of this is ALM, Application Life Cycle Management. This involves software development in a business. Alongside this is requirements management, where stakeholders must be established, then a business case is initiated.
project application management involves prioritising business projects alongside business needs. This is a main focus for Marathon, as they often lose days worth of usage fixing one system where another could have been prioritised. This also brings quality assurance. Lifecycle management also involves project portfolio management, change in configuration management, application performance management, and software asset management, all of which provide a global view of enterprise applications. Most of them attempt and continually
test live applications to keep momentum of the business running smoothly. Elements that Marathon should try to avoid are a large number of languages in the business. It decreases communication and can cause mistakes. Furthermore, ALM should be visible to every member of staff within a business, keeping everyone aware of changes being made and to deliver the right solutions wherever necessary. Marathon Holding PLC have considered a lot of issues and tried to find solutions, but will need to go into more depth concerning time-consuming and costly problems in the business in order to be successful and a worthy competitor in the sportswear industry.